Hello guys, welcome to Tech Mode. And in this tutorial we are going to learn more about basically we are going to understand what is bug life cycle or defect life cycle. So this is a part of series software testing lectures, and so let's get started. So in this tutorial I will basically talk about the life cycle of defect to make you aware the various stages of the defect which basically a tester has to deal, right? A tester has to basically see all the things whenever these whenever any kind of bug or defect arises in your application. So let's understand what is a bug basically, or a defect. So defect in simple terms, as you can say, it's a basically kind of a flaw or an error in an application that restricts the normal flow of an application by mismatching the expected behavior. So suppose you have a requirement, few requirement, and anything which is not related to the requirement and any kind of deviation or error or a flaw is a defect for a software tester or in a software application, right? So the defect occurs when any mistake is made by a developer during the designing or building an application. So when this flaw occurs, basically these flaws has to be found out by a particular software tester rather than an end user who is basically have certain kinds of problems while doing it. For example, suppose there is a particular payment method that is implemented by a software developer according to the requirements, but a user was not able to do the this payment because of certain bug, or a credit card was not accepted due to it. So a tester has to find these kind of defects whenever he was testing the application, right? So a typically defect life cycle, also known as bug life cycle, is basically a cycle of defect for which it goes through, or a defect can go through the different stages in an entire life, right? This starts basically with the new defect whenever we have found. So this is the diagram as you can show. So we have a new status. So whenever new is a basically, you can say it's the first state of a defect whenever a new defect is found or a bug is found, error, flaw, whatever it is, we basically have a status, its defect status or a bug status as a new. So after that, it's basically going to assign to somewhere else, some developer, and if developer start the process of analyzing the defect, and if his say that okay, it is got accepted and it's a bug, then its status change to defect. Else if it is a basically kind of issue, that is we don't want it to do it right now, or basically wanted to defer it, so it's marked this defect is marked as deferred. But if the defect, you can say, is according to our specification and does not harm very much the software application, then definitely developer can reject this app, reject this bug, is because of basically you can say that the bug is not reproducible, or probably the bug is out of scope for him. All right. So after that, when it has moved, developer had basically when developer finishes the task to fixing this bug, then it makes that basically developer changes the status to fixed. After that, what you have to do is that it will basically went to a state where we have to retest the bug consequences. So generally, if we have tested out, we generally go for regression test cases, as well as whatever the bug there basically we have to retest the software application due to this bug. And if we are able to find that this bug is not fixed, then we again do a reopen status and again assign it to developer, which is basically goes to fixed and retest. This is a loop, kind of loop. So when the defect doesn't have any exist any longer and the software application is stable, so it goes to closed state. It looks like a very simple bug life cycle, but here is the advanced one. So this is how in the companies, or you can say the more kind of environment or big companies basically do. So we have a new bug from a users, or you can say any kind of set tester. It goes to a new state, assigned, resolved. And after that, it has an if loop that it can be reopened, verified, and it can be closed after it. So this is another bug life cycle generally used by it. And there are possible status like fixed, duplicate, won't fix, works for me, invalid, remind me letter kind of thing. So It starts with new, and if it is an unconfirmed bug, so basically testers test it out and say that it's a new bug and definitely go for it. And as you can see on the result state, we have like lots of different kind of possible resolutions, like fix, duplicate, won't fix, works for me, like this thing that have been added, more added to the bug lifecycle right now.
All right.
So there are the few points that I wanted to like highlight here, that it's very important before starting to work on the defect lifecycle, the whole team clearly understands it, right? Most of the time, team doesn't understand the bug lifecycle and they just randomly choose the status of the bugs. Another thing important, that bug lifecycle, it's basically be properly documented, and so that we should avoid any kind of future aspects of it. Most of the time, the companies have SLAs. So if the particular bug is come for enterprise, it has a timeline of 1 day or 2 day, and if it is a known enterprise client, we can go for 3 days or 4 days, and more than that we can have a life cycle of it more than one. So this is has to be taken care of. So there are few like questions that we have to understand. So what is the difference between error, defect and failure? So this is one of the important question. So error is if developer finds there is a mismatch, or developer tester find that there is a mismatch in the actual and expected output, then it's an error. A defect, if a tester error is found by developer, and if the defect is basically if the tester finds a mismatch in actual and expected one, that it's a defect. Failure is basically kind of thing when end users are able to find that actual and expected, so this is a failure, right? Generally, most of the time people ask what is producible bug defect. It's a basically defect occurs repeatedly in every execution and whose steps can be captured in every execution, right? So these are the things that you have to keep in mind when you do a bug lifecycle. And one more thing is that you have to take care of bug reporting. So if you have if you are a tester or in your company, then you have to take care of bug report that you have to send for a particular sprints, right? So generally bug reports or a defect report contain defect ID, description of a bug, what are the feature name, test name, and how it is reproduced, what are the steps, what is actual and what is expected. So this kind of columns should exist on your bug report, and you have to like send it after a particular testing that you have done for a particular release. Alright, that's all folks. In this tutorial, basically we have discussion about what is bug lifecycle and all. So if you have any doubt or anything that you wanted to share with me, definitely you can share it out. And do like, subscribe, and let me know about the thoughts if you like this kind of videos where we just discuss about short topic about it, about the software testing as well as programming concepts. So thanks a lot guys, and see you in the next one. Bye.